Hello friends, in this video I will be helping you with the difference between your microprocessor and a microcontroller. So let's start. So if you talk about microprocessor, it is a heart of computer system. So a microprocessor is used in your computers, mobile phones and such big size devices. Okay, whereas if you talk about microcontroller, it is the heart of embedded system. If you talk about embedded system are system that generally do a specific tasks or one or two tasks, that's it. So from the first point we can make out that your microprocessor does a lot of tasks, so they are generally multitasking as well. Okay, but whereas if you talk about microcontroller, they are generally designed for a specific set of tasks, generally one or two tasks. Okay, the second one is it is just a processor, memory and input output needs to be connected externally. Okay, so in case of microprocessor is just only a processor, okay, nothing else. The memory part and your input output parts are connected externally, because you can imagine if they will attach your input output part also and your memory also, then your microprocessor will become very large, right? So generally they are not present inside your microprocessor contains only your processor, that's it. Okay, whereas if we talk about microcontroller have external processor along with internal memory and input output components. So what it says is they not only contain processor within them, they also contain the internal memory as well as input output component. Why so? Because if you see embedded system, most of the embedded system are very small in size, like your watch, MP3 players and so on, right? So in that scenario you want to keep the size of your CPU, or you can say the calculation unit or processing unit, as small as possible. Okay, so that can be done when you will keep everything in just one one component. Okay, but if you will prepare different components for IO, different for memory and different for microcontroller, then size will increase, right? So to avoid that, everything is kept within single microcontroller. Whereas if you talk about microprocessor, everything is, you can say, detached or made separate components, right? Because they are very big in size. Next is your microprocessor cost is high. Why so? Because they are very powerful, they do multitasking and they are generally designed for big systems like a computer and laptops, mobile phones, which needs a lot of calculation, lots of process needs to be executed, right? So the cost also of developing for them is very high. Okay, whereas if you talk about microcontroller cost is very low. Why so? Because they are generally designed for a single or multiple one or two tasks, that's it. So it doesn't need a lot of thing to make your microcontroller. Next is your microprocessor battery consumption is high. Okay, so if you talk about microprocessor, you know it does multiple tasks, right? Even your mobile microprocessor, it does multiple tasks at same time, like call is coming, then you are surfing Facebook or using WhatsApp or using some other application. So it generally do multiple tasks at same time. So because of that, battery consumption is high by your microprocessor. But if you talk about microcontroller, the battery consumption is low. Why so? Because these are generally used in embedded system and your embedded system are generally battery powered. Okay, so if your battery consumption will be high by your microcontroller, then it will be a problem, because generally your embedded system are battery powered, right? You can't change battery again and again. So that's why. But in this case, microprocessor are generally used in your computer system and all, where your current is your AC current. Okay, so in that scenario, battery consumption doesn't hold that much tension as it will in your embedded system. Okay, next is your microprocessor mainly used in personal computers. Okay, you see that personal computer, mobile phones, and here you can say smart devices like this, it is used. Okay, but whereas if you talk about microcontroller, it is used mainly in your washing machine, where you just need to set the timing and what kind of clothes you are washing and 2-3 more things, right? Then your MP3 player, where you need to just play songs, that's it, right? That nothing else you need to do. So just one or two tasks in those components or in those devices it is used. Okay, so this was all about difference between your microprocessor and your microcontroller. So if you found the video helpful, please do hit the like button, do hit subscribing, and thanks for watching.